Thank you. I born in Bihar, relocated to Mumbai for education. The first purpose in my life, because my family, they all studied from a madrasa type of education. So there was a wish of my family members, at least one child in our family should get at least school education. So from Bihar to Mumbai. Mumbai started studying, all the things happened. My life having one connection, and that is sports. Because my grandfather, he was a wrestler. My brother, my uncles, all are from martial arts and all. So some relation is there. I wanted to do sports, wrestling in Mumbai, but unfortunately, I was not able to find in Mumbai. Then that somehow I started learning karate, martial arts, completed my martial arts black belt till 2010. Till 2010, I got more than 50 medals on state, national, and international level. That is a different story. In 2010, unfortunately, because of mismanagement or mishandling by doctors, I got a spinal tumor. Due to operation, I got chest down paralyzed. Now, the story starting here. What after my disability, how I conquered myself? Let me take you very quickly. I think, yeah, this is a beautiful place. This is a pond where I started my first swimming without knowing any technical knowledge about swimming. There is one small home that is my home. And this is a beautiful masjid in my village, Rathos. After 2010, my friends, after my disability, I become chest down, paralyzed. I got a chance to meet Mr. Rajaram Ghag. He is an international para swimmer. And he influenced me to take swimming as a sports. So from here, I started swimming because even doctors told me that it will help you to regenerate your nervous system, which is free of cost somehow. Because going and taking physiotherapy in nowadays, it charges almost around 1,000 to 2,000 rupees for an hour. So it was very costly for me. But then going and finding a real-time obstacle, if being a paraplegic person on a wheelchair, you wanted to go and swim. The moment I enter into the swimming pool there, the lifeguard was seeing and staring at me. Who is here? What do you want? Why you came here? Sir, I wanted to swim. But you're on wheelchair, how you will do? And the worst part, I was alone. Seeing a person on wheelchair, that too alone, for lifeguard, it is a difficult task. No, we can't allow you. I said, okay. And this is the story I'm talking about, 2012. Somehow, as my coach, he was English Channel swimmer, and he said, I'm here, don't worry, he can swim. I entered, I swam across, everything done. Mumbai, from there, 2012 onwards, I played on various levels, state, national, and international level again. I played at various levels, won medals, everything done. Dear students, please make sure I'm going to tell you very important things now. Is after 2016, till 2016, 17, even 18, I played at various level, international level. Recently, in 2019, due to some one of my project, I shifted from Mumbai to Gurgaon. There is one around 2 kilometers near to my home. There is one swimming pool. I went there again, and the same story again. Why are you here? Sir, I wanted to swim. I want to take admission. In 2019, I'm talking. Sir, our pool is 25-meter pool. You will, aap dub jaoge usme. Sir, please allow me. No, no, sir, we cannot allow you. Aap yahan pe dub jaoge. I said, okay. This is the first time, maybe. That's why they are saying, okay, I went back. Came again second day. The moment I came, they said, sir, please, we cannot allow you. I said, please listen to me. I can swim. I know swimming. Sir, we understand you know swimming, but we cannot allow you. I said, why you cannot allow me? Like, what's bother you? Sir, our pool is big. You will fall. Sir, please. I said, okay. Again, next day. This happened with me 4 days continuously. And then, very important, after 4 days, I said, okay, now I think I have spoken to you with all the good things. Please give me in written paper that you cannot allow me. I will, main isme dub jaunga. And they said, okay, sir, main call lagata hu mere boss ko, you can talk to him. I said, okay. And the moment he called, I said, see, my name is Shams Aalam. Oh, sir, you are the paraplegic swimmer. I know about you. Sir, I'm coming since last 4 days. He's not allowing me. He's not even allowing me to give me test. No, no, sir, you please carry on. I will just talk. Okay. Then the moment he allow me to go, sir, again still he's saying, sir, I will allow you, but you need to give me a test. I said, okay, please. At least you can have taken this test on the first day itself. Finally, he took me and allowed me to go inter. I went, I wear my costume and all, and the coaches were there and they were saying, his costume is very expensive. I think he's a swimmer. And the moment I entered, he said, sir, you need to swim 25 meters from here to there. I said, okay. I entered and I continued. Like after half an hour, I stopped for just to have water. Sir, you are a master, sir. Please teach us, our student also. I said, yeah, I'm a master. But just because this master, you guys are not allowing since last 4 days. So the very important point, children, what I wanted to tell you guys here is to please take control, take charge of all your activities. See, this world is, especially people like me think it's very innocent. People will help you around. Everybody is there to help you. But sometimes, knowingly or unknowingly, people may be they are doing their duty. But when they see people on wheelchair, I don't know why their mindset change. I don't know why they think that he or she cannot do anything. So from this platform, TEDxYouth JPSChennai, I would like to give a message to the world that please don't see our disability. See our abilities. We are here. You know, you will be amazed to see if I will show you my disability certificate. In 2012, doctor wrote, he's 100% disabled. I said, 100% disabled if you are writing. Means I'm dead. 100% disabled means he cannot do anything. Okay. No, sir, you are paraplegic. We don't have parameters. Paraplegics are 100% disabled. I said, good. I said, is there any benefit if you are writing 100% disabled? I will get some benefit. No, we don't know, sir, but we don't have parameter. We can write 100%. I said, okay. But yes, I got a benefit. With this, in 2014, I became the world's first paraplegic person with 100% disability to conquer and complete 6 km open sea swimming. Same thing. My disability certificate it's have 5 years times. After 5 years, you need to change it. 2017, I went again back to get my new renewal disability certificate. And now they are saying, it is 72%. Sir, you have reduced your disability. I said, wow, I have reduced my disability. Good. So all thanks to swimming, dear students, do you know one thing? In this world, in this era, the best part we all are having is a human body, and more than human body, a best, a beautiful, creative, more thinkable or more potential, our brain. What I wanted to tell you is, being a child, adult, or anyone, an old age people, please try to use your brain and try to help this world, this community. I will tell you one more thing, what happened this last weekend. In Gurgaon, it's very, very cold. All the swimming pools are closed. All the swimming pools are closed. It's very cold there. Very few swimming pools are there. Those are temperature control. Same guy who said, aap doob jaoge. If you will just Google now, Shams Aalam from our team has created Indian national record in Poland, has cleared, has conquered Ganga River swimming in fastest paraplegic person to swim Ganga River. Okay, so this is all I'm talking about, the real time changes. For a man to conquer himself is the best and noblest of all the victories. People may say that we need a happy life, but I believe in a balanced life. A life in which there should be ups and downs, and that is what something called life. All the gurus and all, maybe sometimes they are just talking about a happy life and all. What do you mean by happy life? Like people, those who are not going with ups and downs, don't they have happy life? So it is my personal suggestion, my dear friends, that then there should be ups and downs in your life. Then only you will understand the real value of life. And then only you will have some experience, and through this, you may share, maybe in the future from this crowd, any of our students will come and share the ideas and the thought, and on this big platform, you guys will come and share your idea. So it is all something like when you have ups and downs. I got to know about myself, my passion, only when all the way I travel from Mumbai everywhere, but I was like going through a normal kid, like, I have to study, yeah, I came here just to study and all. I have to study, I have to learn English, I can at least communicate in English because in my hometown, nobody is able to speak in English. But then, somehow I forgot that something is inner inside myself is a sports person. When I was doing my MBA, master's, not graduation also. Till graduation, like, I don't know what I'm doing. Yeah, I'm doing, I'm learning. I was doing my master's, MBA from very own Satyabhama University in Chennai. And here, while learning management, I focus on myself, and then I realize and I studied about myself, and then I found almost in 100-page story, there is almost 90 pages related to sports only. And I'm not focusing on sports. I'm trying myself to become an engineer, an MBA, and then just going here and there. And then only when I realize that 90% of my life or my activities or my passions is related to sports, dear friends, you won't believe. After my MBA, I did not go for a job. people started questioning, oh, now you are MBA, you are sitting at home, simply going, taking bath in swimming pool and coming back to home. Even my father, you are a useless fellow, you studied this much, not doing any work, simply sitting at home, going, I don't know what you are doing in a gym and taking bath in swimming pool. I said, okay. But in 1 year span of time, I did all these things. After that, in 2018, I represented my country. And that's when my father realized, my surrounding people realized that this guy is not wasting his time. He is investing his time into swimming pool. And that's why today he is able to represent our country. So I would like to give you one message, one single message, my friends, that please believe in yourself. If you have belief in yourself, you can surmount any impregnable mountains in your life. You can cross the rivers and oceans in your life with your tiny hands and everything you wanted to do. So please keep going, keep forwarding, and don't stop until you reach your goal. Thank you so much.